In order to service and fine-tune the rear derailleur, we first need to understand how it works. Hello, Calvin Jones here, Park Pull Company. The rear derailleur is a mechanism that shifts the chains at the rear sprockets. There are many different models, but they all share the same basic design and functionality. Derailleurs are secured to the bike with a mounting bolt to the frame's derailleur hanger. The upper pivot of the derailleur is connected to the lower pivot by a linkage system that forms a parallelogram. Derailleurs use a cage fitted with two pulleys. The lower pulley pulls back to give tension to the lower section of chain. It is called the tension pulley, or T pulley for short. The upper pulley guides the chain to the sprockets, and it is called the guide pulley, or G pulley. On mechanical type derailleurs, a cable is secured at the pinch bolt. When the cable is pulled, the cage is moved inward. A return spring in the linkage will move the derailleur in the opposite direction when the cable is released. With electronic shifting systems, an electrical signal triggers a motor to move the linkage. There is no cable involved in these systems. A derailleur cable passes through the housing to a shift lever. Bikes commonly use an index shifter that moves the cable in small, predetermined increments with each click. Pulling or releasing the cable moves the guide pulley. Barrel adjusters can be located at the derailleur body or the shift lever. They are used to correctly adjust the shifting between cogs. Unthreading or turning the barrel adjuster counterclockwise effectively shortens the cable, moving the G pulley to the left or inward. Turning the barrel adjuster clockwise effectively lengthens the cable. This moves the G pulley to the right or outward. Derailleurs are fitted with limit screws, which are adjusted to stop the derailleur from shifting too far inward or too far outward. We can actually see what the limit screws are doing in this model. The end of the limit screw strikes the linkage, and this stops the pulley travel. The L-screw determines the limit of the innermost cage travel. Tightening the L-screw will restrict the limit to the left side. The H-screw determines the limit of the outermost cage travel. Tightening the H-limit screw will restrict the limit to the right side. It is common to find another adjustment screw on the derailleur body called a B-screw. This controls the size of gap between the guide pulley and the sprockets. Those are the basics of the rear derailleur. Now that you have an understanding of how it works, watch this video to learn how to properly adjust your derailleur. To see all our derailleur videos in one place, check out the Park Tool Guide to Derailleurs. Thanks for watching this repair help video from Park Tool. We're constantly adding videos and articles here on YouTube as well as our website at parktool.com. Please give this video a thumbs up if it helped you out. And of course, subscribe for the latest content from Park Tool.